before I came there, there was every actor. They had, I was like the last actor. They had Nick Nolte, Al Pacino, they wanted De Niro, they wanted Robert Redford, Jimmy Conn. So every actor wanted a different version. They couldn't figure it out. So when I read it, I said, you know, there's a good idea here, but it's a mess because I don't feel any sympathy for the character. So finally, it was really one of the most controversial productions, long productions of any movie ever. I mean, it went through 10 directors, 20 actors. They couldn't figure it out. And I said, the only thing you have to figure out, the man has to have heart. If he has heart, then you'll listen. If he's a savage, who cares? In the original Rambo, he was so savage, so damaged, that he killed many people in the movie, and at the very end needed to be killed like an animal himself because he could never go back to society. So when I got the script and I started working with it, I said, let's make him more of a victim, a fellow who wants to get back in society, but society won't let him. So at the end, I wanted him to have an emotional death where he cries out, I can't find my legs, all my friends. But physically, he stays alive because many Americans were coming back and so depressed the way America was treating them, calling them baby killers and warmongers, they killed themselves. So I thought, I don't want that message. I don't want these men to come back with no hope.
You got some place I can eat around here?
There's a diner about 30 miles up the highway.
Is there any law against me getting something here?
Yeah, me.
So, I told the director that we'll have an emotional death, but not a physical one. He went crazy, and they were going to sue me. So I had to go back 6 months later where they kill Rambo. And I used that in this movie. And when they showed it to the public with Rambo dying, it was a disaster. So they cut it out of the movie. That he was this man-child, a man who was taken at 19 years old and told that your job is to protect America. We're going to train you. We're going to teach you. And what they did is they took a normal human being and turned him into a killing machine, sent him out to kill. He did his job. And when the war was over, they said, well, you're a savage. You can't come back home. You're crazy. We don't want you anymore. And all the Americans spit on him, said, you're a baby killer, because I was just fighting for my country. So he was a victim, and he was so damaged that he never recovered from it. So I think there's a sympathy there that you ask a person to do the job, he does it, and then he has a curse. And he never got over that, especially in the last one.
Name. Hey, if you're looking for trouble, you came to the right place, bud. Oh, wait a second. Hey, you got 3 seconds before I break your face in.
He means it.
Yeah, I do. you know about the old Harry here's a soldier. Rambo. John Jay? You gotta talk to me. I promise you're gonna talk to me, soldier. I'm starting to dislike you.
The first one I thought was very good. I wouldn't change anything on that. The second one, it became more of a fantasy about how America wishes the war had been fought, how they can, do we get the win this time? So it became a physical situation in tank tops and more of a vanity, a lot of vanity, not realistic. And the third one, that was going to be, I thought, important because I wanted to do a movie about Russia's Afghanistan. I mean, Russia's Vietnam. Like we had our Vietnam, after 10 years in Afghanistan, it destroyed their country. And like Vietnam destroyed our country for a long time. But it just didn't work out that way. And it's my fault because there was not enough emotional hookup. In this film, I made it, I think, a little bit more emotional, even though Rambo is a lot harder, a lot, I mean, he's become a beast. I think when people live on the outside of society, they start to become like animals. They don't feel loved. They become more and more savage. So this film is the most powerful, I think, and the best action film I've ever done. There's no question, the first one and the last one, just like Rocky Balboa and the first one, are the most passionate because they're coming from years of thinking about it for many, many, many years. Instead of just writing an action film, I tried to write something that would be politically interesting, educating, but also an entertaining vehicle. So yeah, it's the first and the last one, and the last one is by far the most realistic.